Hello, everybody. Welcome to one of my favorite games of all time, Star Wars Jedi Knight Jedi Academy, as you should have seen in the title of the video, and hopefully that's why you're here. Or maybe you just don't know what it is. But you're not considered a true Star Wars fan unless you've played this game. It has the best lightsaber combat in any game. It's not just like the hack and slash, it's like you actually got to plan what you're doing, and like it's actually deadly. Like, it's actually a lightsaber, it's not just like a stick. Anyway, it was developed by Raven Software. Back in 2003, that was when it was released. And yeah, it's just one of my favorite games of all time. I love it so much. It's right there in my heart. Not even kidding. All right, so let's just start. So I'm going to do Jedi Master because that's the hardest game difficulty. And hopefully this time it actually records because I've already done this once and it's painful. Didn't record. OBS messed up. Anyway, let's get right into it. I know who I'm going to create, so it shouldn't take too long. But yeah, you can like customize your characters and all kinds of stuff. So like you can here, just for example, you can do this guy or Rodian male and all kinds of crazy stuff. It's actually really cool. Yeah, sorry, I'm just gonna rename my character. I hate how it resets. That's the one thing I don't like about that, how it just resets automatically. Anyway, there we go. You get to make also your like your own lightsaber and everything. It's really, really cool. And then later on in the game, you can choose like have another lightsaber dual wield, and you can have like the staff, lightsaber staff, you know, where it comes out both ends like the Darth Maul saber. I think I'm just gonna go with the go with blue, or maybe we can do let's try orange. I've never done orange before. Anyway, let's get right into it. I'm not gonna talk in the cutscenes, so just letting you guys know, except for this one coming up. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away, Star Wars. Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy. Ten years after the Battle of Endor, the Imperial Remnant continues to be driven back by the New Republic, forcing the Imperials to adopt increasingly desperate tactics in the ongoing struggle. I'm sorry, guys. I can't really predict what it's going to say. I mostly just breeze through these cutscenes. Meanwhile, Jedi Master Luke Skywalker moves to restore the Jedi to their formal place as peacekeepers of the galaxy at his Jedi Academy on Yavin 4. Jaden Kor, a promising student from Coruscant, is en route to the Academy after achieving the impossible, creating a lightsaber without any formal Jedi training. This is where the recording messed up. I hope it doesn't. Please don't. It'd be terrible if it does. Oh no, this is where it...
We'll be arriving at the Academy in just a few minutes.
Yeah, it's messing up again. You guys are gonna have to suffer through it like me.
That would be so great!
You don't really gotta watch, you can just listen to it.
Aren't you excited? We're going to be Jedi! Learning the ways of the Force, building a lightsaber. Ah, of course, you already have one. I'm gonna get one of those stupid training sabers and
I wouldn't worry about that.
I can't help it. I want to make a good impression.
You seem really nervous.
Aren't you? I mean, well, why would you be? You already have a lightsaber, so you're probably way ahead of me. I'm Rosh, by the way. What's your name?
Jaden.
So where'd you get that lightsaber?
Well, it's kind of a long story. I found myself on...
Hold on! Ah!
Academy to Yavin Runner 2. Do you copy?
Loud and clear. We made an emergency landing several clicks west of the Academy.
Is everyone all right?
I think so.
Good.
We'll send a shuttle to pick you up. Can you lead the students to the nearby Masasi Temple?
Affirmative, Academy. We'll meet you there.
Here we go. Very first mission.
Jaden, we can't get to you. Make your way to the temple. The shuttle will meet us there.
Jaden, hey! I'm stuck! Can you help?
Hold on, Rosh. I'm on my way.
So right now, I don't have any force powers whatsoever.
It's just see if you can make your way around there. Maybe you can use your lightsaber to cut those trees down and make a bridge.
Just the most, like, incredibly sensitive. I don't understand why.
Thanks, Jaden. Let's get to the temple.
Sorry about that. Wow, still it's like incredibly like there we go, that's much better. Alright.
There must be a way to open this.
No problem.
Oh yeah, he has force powers. I forgot about that. I don't. I only have a lightsaber. Oh, I have force throw. That's pretty much it. Huh. Yeah, this is a really cool game, though. I definitely suggest playing it. I didn't know if there's anything down there. I completely forgot. I haven't played this in a long, long time. But I saw it in my Steam library, and I was like, oh, that'd be kind of fun. Let's play that. Take a break from... Oh, yeah. So normally, down on the bottom, like right here...
Hey, maybe you can use your saber to make another bridge.
He's basically just telling me to cut down trees. Anyway,
Great! Let's go!
Global warming, people. Cutting down trees. Anyway, deforestation. So, you know, anyway, but down here, there's usually 100 health and 100 shield. I only got 100, like, in total. So both of them, so 50 of each. And over here, that's my force bar. So, just letting you know. Just for like a little fun thing there.
Jean, get down! There's stormtroopers in the clearing.
Ooh, stormtroopers, so scary.
Maybe you should check it out. You're the one with the lightsaber, after all.
Oh, I hate this part. I sometimes die there. Just from that, like, one unlucky thing. Hit.
What?
Huh? What? Who are you?
Kyle Katarn, at your service. Welcome to a day in the life of a Jedi.
That's what my favorite happened? Character right there.
We were kind of hoping you could tell us.
I saw a huge flash of light and ran over to find you, just lying unconscious.
Do you recall anything?
I saw three people. One was holding some sort of scepter, and it was glowing. That's all I can remember.
A scepter? That sounds bad.
Are you able to stand?
Yeah, I'm okay.
I sense a disturbance in the Force.
You always sense a disturbance in the Force. But yeah, I sense it too. It could just be residual dark side aura from this temple.
Perhaps. Kyle, why don't you...
Stay here and investigate? I'd love to. Why don't you take the kids back home now?
Be careful, Kyle. Everyone, follow me to the shuttle.
I think that was Luke Skywalker. I can't believe it.
Did you recover Skywalker's records?
Yes. With all the Jedi in the jungle, it was almost too easy.
Excellent.
I'd like to welcome all our new students to the Jedi Academy. Here we will train you in the ways of the Force. You will learn to defend yourself with a lightsaber. You will also study diplomacy, history, and more. It has been the practice of the Jedi to assign each student to a master. However, since there are still so few of us, we will be assigning multiple students to one master. So, Rautheron, you will be assigned to Master Horn.
I can't wait to begin my training.
Rosh Pennant, you will be assigned to Master Katarn. Jaden Kor, you'll also work with Master Katarn. Now, let's begin with your first lessons, and may the Force be with you.
And there was nothing, but the area around the temple felt strange, like its dark side aura was gone.
Troubling. But let's look into this later. Your students are ready to get started.
Master Katarn, it's an honor to be serving under you.
First off, just call me Kyle. Titles make my skin crawl. Secondly, you're not serving under me. I'm going to teach you, and you're going to learn. That's it.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Don't worry, Rosh. You didn't. I've been offended by professionals. Now, let's see what you two kids can do. Follow me to the training grounds.
So he'll make sense, because there, before this, there was actually another Jedi Knight, and it was different. It wasn't. This is like the sequel.
This is one of the many training grounds here at the Academy. I'm going to put you two in separate courses. When you're ready, Jaden, go through that door. Rosh, follow me.
Anyway, as I was saying, he is actually the protagonist in the prequel to this. So, yeah.
This course will familiarize you with your core Force abilities. These are powers that every Force user has. As you progress in your training, you will learn new abilities. Both the light and dark sides will be open to you. Remember, abilities are not inherently good or evil. It's how you use them. Every Jedi is naturally stronger in different areas of the Force, and it will be up to you to decide what to focus on.
Anyway,
let's get started. In the next area, you'll find some training remotes. These will help you learn how to handle a lightsaber. Ready?
Ready!
Ready!
Keeps on interrupting me. Anyway,
here come the remotes.
Where are they? Oh, yeah, they come out of these. On my channel, I have the very first. Hold on. What the heck was that? I hate this part the most.
Nice work, Rosh. You did well too, Jaden. Your lightsaber is an invaluable tool. Even when inactive, it can defuse a potentially volatile situation. Trust me on that. As you train, you'll learn additional fighting styles. Changing styles during combat can surprise your opponent, allowing you to gain the upper hand. From here on out, we'll talk via comlink in each area. Let's move on.
Anyway, the next game I'm going to be playing is Jedi Knight Jedi Outcast. And that's the one that has him as the protagonist, Kyle as the protagonist.
Okay, Jaden. Force to jump across the way. It shouldn't be a problem. Try again.
A long time since I played the Jedi Master. Is there any health pads? Yes, there is. There we go. Sorry, I just figured it's best to have some more of that health. But not. Come on, jump up. Jeez. I hate the stage one force jump. You barely jump up at all. It's honestly really sad.
You'll have to use push to get out of here and into the next area.
Oh no, I skipped that. Shoot, I'm sorry. I'm so used to just normally. Oh man, I should not have skipped that. I'm so used to just normally playing through this and I skip through everything. That won't happen again. I sincerely apologize about that. That's just stupid. Anyway, so what happened was, Rosh, the guy that's supposedly his friend, right? He's up there, and he walks up, and he doesn't like how fast we're completing this. So he sends out this guy, who's supposed to be for advanced Jedi, to kill. So that's what happened. Sorry about that. You can easily just kill him like that. He came out of that door, by the way, that robot thing. Well, he was up there, Rosh was up there hitting the switch.
What took you so long, Jaden?
Nothing.
You're sure?
It was nothing.
To get to the next area, you must pull a lever somewhere in the room. But you can't reach the lever with your hands. Remember to examine your environment carefully. When you're out on a mission, if you find a locked door, look for the guy in charge. He usually has a key.
Oh, shoot. What did I sign it again? Probably something stupid. Hold on. There we go. That's four speed, by the way, this thing right here. And right over here, there's a... Oh, I thought it was a shield thing. It's not a shield thing. It's just a health thing. Sorry, it's been a really long time since I played this. Checkpoint. Nice. I was wondering why I couldn't roll there.
Solutions to problems aren't always obvious. Use your force sense to see if you can find a way out of the room. Okay.
There's a way to get in these. Ah, there we go. It's just, oh man, it's just another... Ah, that's annoying. It's just another health pad. Health pack, whatever. So sometimes, if it's a really, like, big ledge, you can, like, jump duck up to the top, and it gives you a little bit more of, like, a jump boost. It's actually really interesting. That's what I do. You can actually reach quite a few secret areas just by doing this. It gets you up really high. Look, you can't normally jump up that, but you might be able to jump up. No, you can't jump up. But anyway, because you just... Trust me.
Done. You'll need to move fast in this next area. You can use the force to speed up both physically and mentally, allowing you more time to make decisions.
Too easy. Too easy. I'm a professional Jedi.
So, did I win?
It wasn't a competition.
I'm sorry,
I'm not the one you should be apologizing to.
It's no big deal. You said yourself this wasn't a competition.
Hey, it was just a joke. I didn't think it would...
If that droid was set to Luke's training regimen, it would have killed Jaden. What were you thinking?
Jaden, I'm so sorry. I can't believe I... I mean, I wasn't trying to...
Save it, Rosh.
Jaden, you have a right to be angry. But believe me when I say you don't want to feed that emotion.
I understand, Master Katarn. Apology accepted, Rosh.
Good, that's settled. And remember, it's Kyle?
Yes, Kyle.
Sure thing, Kyle.
Okay. You're both ready to start putting what you've learned to use. Let's see how you do in the real world.
Kyle, I did some research on that strange mark from the clothing we found at the temple. It is the symbol of Marco Ragnos, a Sith Lord that died almost 5,000 years ago.
5,000 years? Are you serious? Oh, wait. Of course you're serious.
While you're out training your students, be on the lookout for information regarding a group affiliated with Ragnos.
Sure thing, Luke.
We receive countless requests for assistance from all over the galaxy. Since we believe in learning by doing at the Academy, students of all levels help with these requests. Since you're an initiate, however, Kyle will travel with you on most of your missions in order to instruct you and ensure your safety.
All right, sounds good. Anyway, I think that's where I'm going to end this here. This is the first training missions. Nothing too fun, I believe you. Believe me, it gets so much better from now on. Okay? So just keep it tuned in, okay? Anyway, hope you guys have a great day, night, wherever you guys are, evening, whatever, doesn't matter. Have a good time, I guess. Bye.